every Monday, our first show of the week, I should say, our friends at Kuby Energy help us get the week started off on the right foot. They help us reset our focus. Sometimes they restore our faith in humanity. It's a feature we call positive reflections. We absolutely loved this tweet from Tim Taylor Smith. I've been so excited to show this to you. He says, "Hey, Ryan, some happy news. After being diagnosed with Parkinson's 10 years ago and numerous broken legs, my wife was able to get back and row again. It's a sport she loves." Tim says, "Of course, these are baby steps, but they are steps forward. My wife helped create Canada's para rowing team. Look at this video." For those of you watching on YouTube, check this out. This is Tim's wife, 10 years after her Parkinson's diagnosis, back out on the water doing what she loves. "That made my week, Tim, and I'm thrilled that you shared it with us." How about this one? A writing competition. This is from Michael, who took the time to chime in at talk@ryanjesperson.com. He says, "My daughter has achieved an amazing thing, and I had to write into Real Talk about it." He says, "Early last month, she received a very special letter, a congratulations of sorts, confirming she made it to the final rounds of a Canadian short story writing contest." He says, "With the circus, with the hellscape that is politics in Alberta these days, I thought we could all use some great news about our kids. They've gone through so much over the past few months. It's a ray of sunshine to see what this has done to my daughter's confidence, all the hard work she's put into her writing this summer." He says she chose to write a fantasy story themed around mental health, and she wrote it on a typewriter. He says, "That's right, my daughter is old school. She uses it daily, and it's such a joy for me to hear that keyboard clacking away, that bell ringing when I get home from work." Mike, who signs off as the frontline defender, says, "Oh, and by the way, the publisher is compiling all the winner's stories and publishing as a book. As a dad, I could not be more proud. I hope this story lifts the Real Talk community spirit that even during a pandemic, our kids are still pursuing their passions." Mike, the frontline defender, we love it. And congratulations to your daughter. What an exciting opportunity. This from Danielle, who says, "Real Talkers, I'm so thankful for the job I have. I'm thankful that it allows me to get out of the house to safely socialize with people. Says, I've got two school-aged daughters and a son that was born last March. And when I went on mat leave at the start of the pandemic, it was devastating to be stuck at home without a connection to other moms. I'm a social butterfly, and it was really hard on me. So when my mat leave was over, I was so excited to get back to a work routine. I teach the most amazing people on the planet in a little rural school in Murnham, Alberta." She says, "We have the best kids. I broke down in tears in our first staff meeting trying to express how much I admire everybody around me. Nothing is ever deemed to be impossible. No school-wide project is ever too ambitious, no matter how much work it'll be. Yeah, it is hard work, but it's so rewarding, and I'm grateful for the opportunity to be in Murnham, Alberta." That from Danielle. Danielle's email reminded me of that great advice, bloom where you're planted. I thought that was so beautiful. And this one in closing from Lisa. Lisa says, "I've recently found myself grounded to my home while I recover from some health challenges." She says, "Which for a nature and landscape photographer, well, that's akin to torture. Well, autumn takes hold and the landscape has such beautiful explosions around us." She says, "I decided I still needed to create. So I headed out to photograph autumn in my yard as best I could in my favorite way with my macro lens." She says, "I hope that these images bring as much joy to you as they did to me." Says Lisa to all Real Talkers, "Have a wonderful week." Well, Lisa, you made our day. You've knocked our socks off. And thanks for sharing. If something happens in your world, something that puts a smile on your face, something that reminds you about perspective, something that encourages you in a way that really prompts you to take pause, we'd love to hear it. And so would our friends at Kuby Energy. You can submit your positive reflections anytime to talk@ryanjesperson.com or hit us up on Twitter with the hashtag RealTalkRJ. Coming up on tomorrow's show, as promised, we'll have in-depth coverage, analysis of the results of the municipal elections happening today in our home province of Alberta. Get out and vote, Real Talkers. Plus, former hockey star Bernie Sanders will join us about his new autobiography, Shut Out, The Game That Did Not Love Me Black. Bernie Sanders coming up on Real Talk tomorrow. In the meantime, make it a great Monday, friends. We'll see you soon.